I'm lagging. I can't even get into the car. Where do you go?
I'm in a car.
I can't even get into the car.
Just E.
Yeah, I'm pressing E. It's not able to get in.
Alright, now I will walk around. Come. This was where we placed our hub and all.
I can get into the one you were in, right?
You can?
Yeah, and now I can't get into it.
I don't know, maybe because you haven't unlocked it.
Probably. Okay, well.
Alright, when you start the game, it's best to start near iron mines. Usually,
yeah,
iron mines.
I set up my hub next to an iron mine.
Yeah, so there's three iron mines here.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, come. I'll show you what we did with iron first. We started off here, I mean it was a big mess, and then after like twice deleting everything and then restarting from scratch, this is what we've come to. But I mean this entire factory is basically built by me. Kevin was working on fixing the research. We've got tons of these smelters.
Oh yeah.
All the ore goes into these.
To...
I mean if you see, I've used three layers of feeding, if you look above. So there's no clock, there's like 18 smelters all the way up till the end. Come follow me. And even 18 smelters isn't producing fast enough, so then I had to put like 5 more.
I'm using near the water.
Yeah, I mean we can just build foundations or anything on this game, so that's nice. We've got a bunch of smelters here as well who are feeding into these constructors. Behind the smelters, you'll see constructors, right?
Yeah, I see that.
So, three key things we need in this game from iron. That is iron sheets, then we need the screws, and then we need iron rods.
Yeah.
So I've got three of each alternate. So those three were iron plates. Here we've got iron rods, and then you've got three screws. And the same trend goes all the way back. So since there are 18 of them.
So you have 18 smelters, so
6 each. And then all of this, as you can see, there are 3 conveyor belts systems again. Each conveyor belt is for one item. So the top one is for...
How did you automate all this?
How? What do you mean? Like placing them by hand and putting them up?
No, like automating the process of making all the like the rods and the screws and stuff.
The conveyor belts you have to place on your own, everything you have to... It feeds on its own, you don't do anything. I mean, if you place a conveyor belt next to a machine, next to the output end, then the machine will automatically feed its output into that conveyor belt.
Okay.
And all these conveyor belts, I've put 3 storage sections. You can see one storage section here. This one is for iron rods. So all rods come here.
Yeah.
Iron rods are usually in very high demand, so I should get more production. Same with the screws. These
screws in here.
You need like thousands and thousands of screws. I've got screws here, I've got screws producing behind there, I've got screws producing on the first floor, and here I've got the iron sheets. Now, this is just tier 1 level. All this is used and consumed in manufacturing by these assemblers. They're making reinforced iron plates. 6 of them, I think, I've put on reinforced iron plate duty. Then you've got 8 of them on reinforced iron plates. So that's taken care of. Because you'll need tier 2 and tier 3 products, and most of them will need reinforced iron plates. Here I'm making a bunch of screws.
Your character just did the.
It's lagged,
dude.
The game is not optimized for network.
You're doing the Naruto run on my screen. Wait, where do you go, though? You're just teleporting on my screen.
It's lagged, dude, the game. And here I'm making modular frames. And here
what
I'm making
these
rotors. Modular frames are used in making heavy modular frames, and then and also in using buildings. I mean, if you go to production, and if you see manufacturers, then miner Mark II foundries, all those require these modular frames.
Oh.
And as time goes, you need to build buildings that that rely on even heavy modular frames, like manufacturers. They need heavy modular frames, so that is built after modular frames.
Okay.
So this whole level is dedicated to tier 1 and tier 2, and once everything is built up, you can see on this side, they're all teleported up.
Okay, and where do they go?
Come here. Do you see this whole, the big tower here? You can climb this up. For I mean, initially I use these. You can also use jump pads to get up. This is tier 2, level 1. Let's go to the other corner.
Why are they different color, like foundation block?
Oh, dude, we were playing with the guns. We unlocked the color guns, we just played with them.
Okay.
Initially, we thought we'll color code everything, but then it was too much work, apparently. Right, just here.
Oh, hello.
So, you see, when we have set up with iron, the next stage will be steel. And
yeah.
For steel, you need iron and core. So the top conveyors you see on top of, they're bringing in coal, because coal is very far away, like 1.5.
Oh, you're just mining them from far off and then transporting.
Yeah, coal is like 1.5 kilometers away. So and there are 3 mines, and we are mining all of them with Mark II miners. Because with iron ingots,
you just disappeared. Yeah, there you are. Yeah, you were saying.
No, because these are foundries, right? The first stage, first level items.
Yeah.
So these foundries build iron ingots. And they can be used to make either steel beam, or you can make with them steel pipes. You need both of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. Well, as you can already see, my production is pretty backed up, so.
Yeah.
I saw a video.
A huge ass light on top.
What light? Probably the sun, dude.
The tower.
Oh, that's the space elevator.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's a space elevator. This is a copper production setup. I'll go into copper.
Where's your mine?
Which mine?
Your ore, copper ore.
Copper is down. If you come south. Okay, I can actually show you copper from here. It's not a big setup. You see that single in the corner, southeast corner, there's a mine.
Yeah.
And I've got a bunch of smelters, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six
Wait,
smelters
one
are
mine is feeding all those smelters.
Yeah, I mean 6 smelters because you need 60 per minute, and it's a Mark II, and I've put some power shards, so the production is constant.
Okay.
And then that is feeding iron ingots into the storage boxes, which are then feeding copper ingots, which are then feeding the copper production. You make 3 items from copper. One is the copper wire. Then
which you need for power and stuff.
You use copper wire to make normal cables, and then all you use the copper ingot again to make copper sheets. So 3 are making copper sheets, 3 are making wire cables, 3 are making copper wires. Since the production was enough on the western side, I've put up a second all the way across this factory. It's another factory altogether. You can see a small conveyor belt bringing in a ton of which is stopped, right, barely moving. That's coming from the other factory. And this factory is pretty slow, as you can see, so I had to boost from that side. Anyway, there's a railway. You saw the video, right, on the train station?
No, I didn't.
Okay, this is the Hub East station.
Mm-hmm.
Which map did you start on?
The grassy map.
Okay, so if you take this train, it'll take you all the way to the grasslands.
Oh, okay.
There are 4 starting locations, the map is the same.
It's the same planet, just different location.
Yeah. And if you take a train, it goes all the way to the grasslands.
Uh-huh.
Right. So we've covered the steel as well. So I'll show you more. I put storage depots everywhere. So this one's collecting steel beams. On the other side of the factory, steel pipes are collected. Where are you going? Are you going north?
Yeah, I'm heading north.
Okay, in the north where you see the storage boxes, right?
Yeah.
You can see like 6, 7, 4 of them in front, and then 2 more behind it. That's basically the...
What are these crystals here near the river?
Oh, that's quartz crystal.
Okay, what do you use that for?
We can make 2, I think. This is raw silica. Quartz. We can make silica and we can make quartz crystal from this. Quartz crystal is used as in one of the parts for computers. Oh, you fell down. Silica is used in aluminum production. Right. Come next to the whole bunch of storage cans with the steel pipes. So, as you can see, again, multiple layers of conveyor belts, one bringing the pipes, one taking them. And as you come to one of the assemblers, the first assembler, this one's making stators. Stator is
making
one of
what?
The only items. Stator, right? You can see here, press E.
Okay.
You can see the recipe. So,
yeah,
it needs
okay.
pipe
and I didn't
wire.
Hear what you said.
Okay. Starters are one of the only items which aren't used in any form of building. So they can only be used to produce more units, and it's already backed up. So I mean, this is what the starters used to make motors.
Is it possible to automatically, suppose if you have a low requirement of some material, can the smelters automatically start producing something else for
No. Because then you'll have to change. I mean, the inputs has to be changed, right?
Yeah,
Two inputs
there's some way
will
to
always
automate
make
that.
the
That'd
same
be pretty
product.
cool.
I mean,
Start from the beginning. Say you have enough of starters and you want more steel rods or something. Just
no, it's gonna be
ask the system to change the inputs to the machine and then
no, because
produce
we
them.
are manually placing all the conveyor belts and everything, right?
Yeah.
It's gonna be everything has to be either automatic or manually. If you move forward, these big ass buildings, these are manufacturers. So here you can see they're making the heavy modular frames.
Yep.
And if you follow me, you'll find again AI. These are making AI limiters. Then there are other computer parts being made ahead. The manufacturers are making. See the crystal oscillator. This is using quartz crystal.
What are the oscillators used?
In computers, you need oscillators to make a computer.
Okay.
If you come to this one, there's an assembler. This is an alternate recipe. So it's making a crystal computer for us.
Cool.
These
Takes
computers.
64 seconds to make one.
Hey, it's pretty slow. I mean, you need. These are like tier 4, tier 5 products. So. And these computers we're using to make supercomputers. Down
And
here,
this is
these
where the
two.
research comes in.
Yeah, they're all unlocked by research. I've put it on standby because we don't need supercomputers, we need computers. Anyway, and you can see on the southern side, if you come, there's a whole bunch of screw production again.
Oh, okay.
We can never have enough screws, man. And right now the screws are backing up only because all the production machines and manufacturers have been shut down because we don't need those parts. Come, I'll take you on
You
a
can't
trip.
redirect these to somewhere where you need it.
We don't need them. I'll just let them back up because the mines will never run out.
Okay.
So it's best to have, and you're better off having resources when you need them than not having them when you need them, right?
At all, yeah.
Come to the station. Come to the Hub West station. Fast.
West one?
Hub West.
Yeah, okay. I see it.
You can set up automatic trains. So this train.
Can these trains transport goods as well?
Yeah, this one train, you'll see the animation right now. This train is automatically bringing aluminum from the aluminum plant. You can probably see on your hub there's a train station.
Yeah, I see the plant there.
Let's jump on the train and we'll travel. You can actually go inside the train. Come on the engine.
I don't see the engine.
Dude, the engine is in front of the train.
No, I just see the rails. I don't see any model of the
electric locomotive.
Oh, there it is. I see it. It didn't load on my screen.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm in.
Okay. We'll just.
This is no power.
No, it will work on its own. You can't touch it because it's automatic.
Okay, I'm inside the train. But...
Yeah, it'll go move. Dude, stop trying to move the train.
Wait, I'll stand on top. I dragged into the train. I'm inside the train, right?
Okay. I'll
I
show you
keep
the other
lagging
one.
Into the train.
I mean, it's a neat feature. Wait, the game's here. It's a neat feature to have automatic trains, and you can even have automatic trucks.
Mm-hmm.
Right, we've reached our station. Let's get up. Yeah, I can see it. Right,
cool.
Aluminum is the most complex thing to make because it's a pain. Because what you need is first come towards the west. You'll
yeah,
see a bunch
see.
Of pipeline. That's bringing
yeah.
water all the way from the sea.
Okay.
Now you feed water and bauxite to these refineries and they make alumina and silicon.
This is like chemistry class all over again.
Yeah, and to the alumina solution you have to feed petroleum coke.
Wait, where do you go? You just disappeared.
I'm at the water tanks.
Oh, I'm at the bauxite area. Or copper, sorry.
Yeah, because I mean, alumina production is much higher than the consumption right now. And you need copper, and you can see silica also coming in.
Yeah.
So all that goes into these one assembler that is making aluminum for us. And that is being taken by the train.
It's being taken, the finished product is being taken by the train to
yeah.
the hub. Okay.
This was done by Kevin.
Mm-hmm.
We just needed 200 or 400 of these alkalad aluminum sheets to get to the next level. And you can use the sheets in making Mark V conveyor belts. So other than that, we haven't been using or working on alumina a lot. This is just the bare minimum that we did. Because
you don't need it much, right?
No, I mean, from the now on, we need a lot because we need to make heat sinks, we'll need to make nuclear power plants, they need turbo boost, they will need turbo engines. You need heat sink for turbo engines. So,
mm-hmm.
I mean, this is like high tier shit.
By the way, how do you attach like the material to come to the train station and then get loaded onto the train?
Oh, if you come, you can configure the train. There's a timetable tab.
Uh-huh.
And then on the freight platform, you can change settings to load, unload. Jump, because once it picks it, it'll kill you.
The train is not moving on my screen. It's like stuck in the middle of the bridge.
It's lag, that's all.
Oh, okay, I'm here. Oh wow, the lag is real.
It's usually better at night.
I don't know where I am.
Just get on the train. Just get inside the train if you can. But don't press any button because it's automatic, right?
Oh, dude, I can't. Okay, let's see. Did I get it?
I think so.
Because
you're moving with the train.
My game just.
Yeah, I think you're moving with the train. Oh, by the way, if you look on the bottom on the south side, you'll see blue color sheets coming. That's plastic.
Oh,
I see.
Okay,
you can run faster if you press C and then you press space. When you're running, press C, press space, and then C again, and then we.
Oh shit! I think I just died.
No, the train doesn't kill anyone.
Oh.
It has no hit.
No, but I fell down. But.
Oh yeah.
Alright,
stay down. Come down. I'll come down. I'll show you the power plant.
What power does it use? Like what?
Coal. This one is coal power plant. We have oil power plant as well, but it's too far away. Where'd you go?
I'm at the water extractor.
Right. So these water extractors and coal. Can you see the coal on conveyor belts?
Yeah, I see them.
So these all feed into these gigantic coal power plants. Each of them makes around 75 megawatt of power.
That's it?
Yeah, I mean, we used to have biofuel. I mean, you're at level 1, right? So you probably collect
leaves and sticks as biofuel.
So they make like 20 megawatt. And you can't even automate that. You have to manually collect. If you go to one of the poles, any of the power poles, and just press E, you'll see that we're consuming about 1900, 2000 megawatt. And we're producing 4300. I mean, we can produce 4300, so that's pretty sick.
Ooh. I see you.
Okay. So this bit, you can see some of the conveyor belts that's bringing the copper. So this is the second copper factory. That's on the ground floor. But come upstairs. I mean, if you look at southeast, that's where we were. That's the first floor of the ground. I mean, that's where the steel factory and everything is.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to put the higher tier stuff, computers, supercomputers on the third floor. I'm gonna move them later on. But
Okay.
before we look at Bot Blow, we'll go up. This is what I did today. This is solely producing quickwire.
Caterium, caterium.
Yeah, caterium ingots from caterium ore. And these, they're like 16 constructors, 8 each on both sides. And you can see the split conveyor belt system below that's feeding them, bottom fed. And if you come here, the reason I had to put them inside the box is so that it lags less, because there's less items to render. And here,
Oh.
you can see there are 12 smelters, six on each side.
They smell the ore into the
Into the ingot. And all of this is being fed by this storage unit here, which
Did
of
you say
course,
one?
yeah, I mean, storage unit is empty anyway. Because,
Okay.
I mean, there are 12 of them, right?
Yeah.
Each of them consume, you can see what rate they consume, 60 a minute. Or is it 45? They consume 45 a minute, so 12 of them, that's 480. And I've got a
Yeah.
Mark II miner with two power shards, so that's also make producing 480 a minute. So I don't actually need
Where do you find these stars?
what the power
Where do
shards.
you find?
You have to build them with snail. Have you seen any glowing snails?
Yeah, I harvested one, some green energy snake.
Yeah, so when there's a research in your MAM, once you do it, MAM research, you can make power shards.
Oh.
And power shards will boost the production. They're not very energy efficient, but the thing is, the nearest Caterium ore after the one that we're using, I mean, the one we're using is like 150 meters from where we are. The other one is 1600 or so. Yeah, 1300 meters
Wow.
from where we are, so it's too far away. So I can't, I mean, right now, this seemed easier. And both of these, as you can see, I mean, bottom feeding the ore and top feeding the ingots, they're going into the storage here, which are feeding those. And on top, this layer is where all the, well, the quickwire is being collected.
What I use the wires for?
Multiple things. If you take out your Mark II poles in power, they use quickwire.
Okay.
And these quickwire are going to computers and other manufacturers because they need tons of these per items.
Okay.
And that's basically like 80% of the factory. What you haven't seen is the oil setup. Come, I'll show you that. Getting to the oil setup is pretty fun because you
What are
can
these
take.
green smoke plumes I see
Oh,
everywhere?
those are poison. Don't go there, you'll die.
Oh.
Usually, you'll find a snail in these green fog.
Yeah, these things, yeah.
To get them, you can craft a gas mask,
Uh-huh.
and with a gas mask filter, you'll be fine. Come to the hub station,
Hobby station.
hub west. We're going
Hub
to oil.
West.
Oil is also a very limited resource, and it's usually very far away. So if you look at
So
east, if you
limestone.
look at south, you'll see sulfur. We
This
will
is the
collect.
limestone mine.
But if you look
Okay.
towards the east, you'll see a sulfur as well. Sulfur is a very
Wow.
rare, small use item. Where did you go? Your limestone, right? Come next to limestone. Do
Yeah.
you see these pipes, transparent pipes?
Where?
Towards the north of the limestone mine.
Yeah, I see them.
Yeah, these are tubes. We'll take them now. We'll
They
travel them.
transport oil or transport tubes.
Yeah, I mean, hyper tubes. Hyper loops.
Are these powered by just regular cables?
Electricity, yeah.
Okay.
I mean, these oil is so far away, we can't travel. Even by train, it's slower. So we just put tubes instead. And you can see the conveyor belt bringing plastic all the way.
Yeah. You'll find the oil.
And we tried to build a train station and tried to automate it, but we failed. So we
Why
just,
would I?
I mean, it was the first try, so,
Oh,
and we
okay.
needed plastic very badly, so we just put a conveyor belt instead. This is an oil. Where you can
Oil
feel.
refinery.
Well, I mean, you've got oil extractor, and then that's
Yeah.
feeding into these.
Tubes.
Yeah, I mean, the tubes are into these refineries. These refineries. Why is everything
Hello?
stopped here?
Can you hear me? Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay.
Come southwards, and you'll see a massive, massive oil refinery.
Yep, see it.
Dude, that's a
Was
small
it
bit.
large
This is
enough?
oil power. This is just power here. Do you see how many? This is all built by Kevin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We've got 9 over there. They're producing power from oil. And we've got another 8 or 9 on eastern side.
Everything was built by Kevin.
Yeah, this whole bit was built by Kevin.
Why can't I get faster?
Oh, you don't have the special
Jump
Blade
thingy.
Runners. Yeah, Blade Runners. You can unlock those and they almost double your running speed. Thing is, we just went massive scale because these oil power producers can make oil at the rate, I mean, power at the rate of 150 megawatts. So they make double than that of coal, and they are more, well, fuel efficient. So we just expanded this instead. Also, we ran out of space to expand our coal production anyway. So this was basically the tour of our factory. Do you have any questions, anything you want to know? If you press Z, you can see the map. I think you can see the map, right?
Yeah, I can.
You have to unlock it, so I don't think, I mean, I
No, I
meant
can see the map.
now you can, but in your game, you have to unlock it, right?
Yeah.
You'll probably be able to see only the map which we've explored, and that's like what, half? Less than half we've explored.